So, you've got yourself an unfavorable lane. Whatever trade you do, the enemy will always outtrade you. So the goal in the lane is to minimize the incoming damage as much as possible. Let's break it down. There are two ways you can do so. The first one is to actually minimize the time you are spending in the lane. And this is achieved by simply making sure that the creeps are always bouncing from tower to tower. Right now, I did fail my block, but I have also noticed that Shadow Friend has been overblocking. So in the end, I let go, and the creeps will meet under Shadow Friend's tower. What that means is that the tower will hit those creeps naturally, and SF will be too busy hitting those creeps to punish me. So now I can simply stay outside of range for his raises and threaten some last hits. And this brings us to number 2. If you threaten last hits, the enemy will have to choose. He can either harass you, or he has to save spells to take those last hits. This applies here, and also applies to other matchups. For example, VR will want to use power shot for both creeps and harassment. But if you threaten the range creep, for example, she will want to prioritize that, and if you move out of the way, she will get the last hit, but the harassment will not be complete. Same here, SF will want to last hit this creep, he has low base damage, he will want to use the raise, and I will move out of the way, and in the end what happens is he uses raises on the creep, not on me. Just like that. And yeah, my ideal goal is to keep the base bouncing. The second best thing to do is to have the creeps on their own high ground. This always creates a scenario where the enemy might miss, and in that case he will still want to use raises for harassment. So ideal positions is creeps bouncing and your high ground. You can also always do the creep aggro to turn this high ground creep position into a tower position, which in the end, again, will make the waves bounce. By simply standing there and threatening a last hit, we will force SF to use the raise. So far, it's the second lane, and we haven't had creeps sitting in the middle, because that would be disadvantageous for us. So again, we'll keep the waves bouncing, or are on our own high ground. We didn't need to block the creeps, because if we don't block, they end up again in the SF's tower range, which is ideal for us. Because again, SF will have to choose, either harass us, or miss last hits. If he wants to do both, I will make sure not to be in the range for the last hits. And the wave bounces back again. The next wave is again meeting on our high ground. And this is the ideal positioning and play for when a matchup is not good for you. Keep the waves bouncing and make the enemy choose between either the last hit or the harassment. Looking for me? It's a very short topic. Simply show the visual, explain the principle, and now I think I will leave you with the rest of the match. Thank you for watching. Good luck.
Stupendous! myself. You had your warning.
For Radiance Middle Tower.
Over here now!
Radiant should look to their middle tower. They have fortified their structures against
the Normally.
Let the fun begin!
Tis my
magic thyself out of that.
Is under attack.
Magic thyself out of that.
Where's the party?
Pony!
Told you a storm was coming.
Normally.
Radiant's bottom tower is in danger. Radiant's top tower is in danger.
Is mine.
I'll take that. Radiant's bottom tower is under attack. Dire structures are fortified. Radiant's top tower is under attack.
Disappointment.
Dire's bottom is under
yourself out of that.
Dominating! for Radiant forces.
A disappointment.
Give them a drubbing they'll not soon forget.
Magic thyself out of that.